Hello, and welcome to this training on accelerating time to market for safety critical designs. Today, we'll be hearing from Neil Stroud from Core AVI, who will explore Core AVI's collaboration with Intel to accelerate the development and deployment of safety critical designs across multiple market sectors. Let's get started. Neil, take it away.
Hi, and welcome to this session where we're going to talk about accelerating time to market for your safety critical designs. My name is Neil Stroud, and I'm VP of Business Development at Core AVI. So hopefully over the next 15 minutes, we'll give you a good insight into how our partnership with Intel will help you accelerate your designs in any safety critical platform that you have in InDesign. So first of all, I wanted to give you an introduction on who exactly Core AVI is. So we were founded in 2005, so we're just celebrating our 15th anniversary. And as you can see from the map there, we have a global presence across the globe. And we're all about safety critical design. So we have a long proven track record, especially in the avionics space, delivering to high levels of safety integrity. Our business covers three business areas. The first of which is around software, so specifically around drivers and libraries. And we'll get into more detail as we go through the presentation. The second part is actually delivery of certifiable hardware IP. And this is around, especially for designs within the avionics space, around a very specific form factor. The third part, and really critical for the avionics space, but also for other verticals as well, is around extended supply of product. So especially when we think about avionics requirement for longevity of supply being typically 15 or 20 years plus, we can help mitigate some of that risk by taking on that supply and storing it for a longer period of time. A key part of this is enabling innovation throughout the marketplace and through our people and our partnerships, including Intel, of course, we're enabling this to happen in an accelerated way. So now switching gears and talking about focus industries. Of course, functional safety and safety is critical to us all in the modern world. And our history and our pedigree has always been in the avionics space, which includes commercial avionics, military and defense applications as well. And in this space, we typically see very high levels of safety integrity. If you think about the airline industry, we always feel safe when we're flying due to the systems that are in there. But of course, there are many other industries that have functional safety requirements where we need safety. And automotive is one of those, and of course, industrial IoT, and also transportation. So if you think about in the automotive space, both traditional cars that we all drive today, but the trend towards fully autonomous vehicles, of course, we all expect those to be very safe when we get into them. And from an industrial point of view, think about applications like robotics. If you imagine a production line where we see multiple robots building cars on a production line or building white goods, consumer goods, there's a trend there where those robots are becoming uncaged and working in very close collaboration with the humans. So again, of course, these need to be very safe. So Core AVI is all about safety software leadership, and I think this covers and includes multiple facets. First one, of course, is around certification, and looking at any of the verticals we just discussed on the previous slide, there are multiple certification standards out there that we have to adhere to. So the first one here that you see listed is the DO178C, which applies to avionics systems, and the DALA really is just about the levels of safety integrity. That means how safe a system should be. So if you think about things like flight control systems and instrumentation, of course, they have to be available to the highest levels of safety integrity. So that's what the DALA refers to. But as we think about automotive and industrial, these also have their own certification standards. So the ISO 26262 applies to automotive and IEC 61508 applies to industrial systems. And again, the Core AVI products are certified to the highest levels in both of those standards, being ASIL D for automotive and SIL 3 for industrial. What we are seeing as we engage with customers more and more in these other verticals is there's good synergy and adoption from the aviation pedigree that we have. And especially if we think about automotive as well, you know, safety critical graphics, there are so many use cases beyond avionics where this is applicable. And as we look at autonomous systems across the verticals as well, such as robotics and autonomous machines and autonomous robots, autonomous cars, of course, those designers are looking to the avionics space who've been doing autonomy for a long, long time with things like autopilots to understand how we can take those systems and cost reduce them and size reduce them and put them into these vehicles and these robotic systems. The final point here is around reducing the total cost of ownership for safety. As we all know, for those of us who've worked in the safety domain for a while, we know that it does add a burden, whether it's through process or whether it's through incremental features and capabilities that have to be included in the platform. So I think it's incumbent on all of us in the safety domain to help accelerate those time to market capabilities and enable shorter time to market, shorter time to certification, whilst also enabling innovation and customization within those designs. So we strongly believe that there's a baseline set of capabilities that we can deliver between us, and that enables this customization to happen whilst at the same time reducing that barrier to entry and reducing that total cost of ownership for safety. So what exactly is it that Core AVI delivers? So this slide gives an overview of the majority of our portfolio, and everything that you see here will be supported in conjunction with the Intel Tiger Lake SoC that we'll talk about in a moment. So at the base here, in the blue box at the bottom, you see a product called VK Core SC. This is a safety critical implementation of the Vulkan standard API that you see used in gaming and consumer applications. It becomes safety critical because we go through the extra rigors that are required by safety designs to make sure this product has been developed to the stringent standards that we talked about earlier on in the presentation. Sitting on top of these, you can see six boxes across the middle of the slide. As I go through these from left to right, the first one is VK Core GL. So this is for safety critical graphics applications. So again, if you think back to things like cockpits in the avionics space or even the cluster in a modern vehicle, there are certain safety critical requirements placed on the graphics as they show up on the screen. If you imagine in the vehicle, for example, you have the telltales or the engine light. These are safety critical. You need to know that if something happens, they get rendered correctly and pass the information on to the driver. Exactly the same in a cockpit. You know, if you have your artificial horizon, you need to know that that's been rendered correctly so the pilot knows that he's flying straight and true. So these are libraries that enable those graphics to be rendered in a safety critical way. So we have VK Core GL SC1 and SC2 for the two derivatives of safety critical OpenGL. The next two boxes, Encode Core and Decode Core, are targeted at safe applications using video streaming where you need codecs. So think of things like H.264, H.265 applications where you need to encode and decode those video streams. The next product, TrueCore, is especially important for any safety design where you have graphics and actually also compute that's happening on a GPU. It's a capability that monitors the GPU pipelines and checks for safety integrity to make sure the GPU pipelines are operating correctly from a safety point of view. So you can monitor where you have an issue and perhaps you want to go and signify a safe state to the system or to the application and take action on that. The final two boxes, Compute Core and VK Core VX, are more focused on implementation of compute on the GPU. So Compute Core is a certified library of both BLAS and FFT functions. So typically where you require safety certified math functions like matrix multiplication, fast Fourier transforms, and such like. The final product there, VK Core VX, is actually a safety critical implementation of the OpenVX 1.3 standard, where you're looking at an API to do compute on GPUs, looking at things like artificial intelligence applications, such as, again, autonomous systems, as well as video capture and video processing. So all of these combine together to provide a robust middleware framework, part of the overall software stack that will be deployed in any safety critical system across multiple industries. So from a deliverables perspective, we're excited to be partnering with Intel to enable a lot of these designs to happen in the safety critical domain. For Tiger Lake, this is exactly what we're going to deliver together. So firstly, the certification, artifacts and evidence and collateral. As we talked about before, covering multiple standards such as DO178C and DO254 for the software and hardware elements within avionics, respectively, ISO 26262 for automotive, and IEC 61508 SIL3 for industrial and robotics applications. The next part is the software deliverables. As you saw on the previous slide, this is a summary here, so allow me to reiterate. So VK Core SC, that base safety critical Vulkan driver, the VK Core GL SC1 and ST2 OpenGL derivatives for safety critical applications, the Encode Core and Decode Core codecs for safety critical video streaming, decode and encode, the TrueCore product for monitoring the GPU pipelines and checking for safety integrity, the Compute Core libraries that we talked about for BLAS and FFT functions and math functions, and then VK Core VX for OpenVX 1.3 safety critical applications looking at video and AI applications accelerated on the GPU. The next part is a single board computer hardware IP. So Core AVI don't actually deliver the boards themselves, but what we do offer is a licensed IP package around the 3U VPX form factor that I talked about at the beginning of the presentation. So this is a form factor that's used extensively within the avionics space for cockpit systems, flight control systems. So it's a standards-based approach and aligns very nicely with the Intel ecosystem. This is a licensable package that any customer can take and work with a contract manufacturer to build his own board for deployment within his own systems or to sell on to his customers. A key part of that, obviously, is working with the ecosystem and the software ecosystem, especially around delivery of real-time operating systems and the BSP support that goes with it. And there are a number of partners out there who support these systems today. And finally, of course, the Tiger Lake SoC itself. So this is the i7-1185GRE product, which sits on the Intel embedded roadmap. It has a 7-year lifetime standard. Of course, as I said at the beginning, we'll also extend that lifetime where it makes sense for customers who require that upwards towards 20 years of availability for long lifetime availability. So I think together we're very, very excited to be working with Intel to accelerate any safety design across multiple verticals where we can deliver and enable system design, innovation, certification, and accelerate that deployment with any given market vertical. So finally, call to action. Hopefully you've seen in the last 15 minutes or so that we do have a strong proven track record in delivering safety critical software and work extensively to enable this across market verticals, taking our pedigree in the avionics space and translating that and transposing into adjacent markets such as automotive, including autonomous systems, smart manufacturing, and industrial. The Intel Core i7-1185GRE is definitely a compelling product for multiple use cases in the embedded space, especially focusing on the avionics use cases I talked about before. This will be the first one that you see go to market with the partnership between Core AVI and Intel, but closely followed by solutions in automotive and industrial as well. Finally, this partnership that we have, I think, drives extra confidence into the ecosystem. It's a very robust partnership. I think it's the first of many products to come, and hopefully you've seen how this will accelerate your designs and get you to market faster with the confidence that you can get through the certification phase with ease. So thank you for watching, and I think now we're opening up for a question and answer session, so I look forward to hearing your questions if you have any things you'd like to bring up. Thank you.